Hello and welcome to Empower IAS. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic related to your CSAT paper 2. The name of the topic is boat and steam. For some student, this topic is very difficult, and for others this is very easy. So boat and steam. Okay, suppose first we will learn the related concept and then we will do some examples to get 100% clarity of this topic. Okay, so suppose this is a river and flow of river is in this direction. So suppose this is water flowing. Okay, this is a water flowing and flow of water is in this direction, and here there is a boat and a person is sitting on the boat. Boat is also running in the direction of flow of water. Okay, water is flowing in this direction and boat is also flowing, moving in this direction of flow of water. Okay, suppose speed of boat in still water is x kimi per hour, and speed of water is y kimi per hour. Okay, so we are supposing that the speed of boat in still water is x kilometer per hour and speed of water or speed of river or speed of steam is y kilometer per hour. Okay, suppose if you are on the boat and your boat is moving the direction of flow of water, then what will be the combined speed? And if you are moving in the direction of flow of water, then that situation or that kind of travel or journey will be said as downstream. Okay, and if you are moving or traveling against the water, it means against the direction of flow of water. You are moving here in the direction of flow of water, and in this is the case first. And if your boat is moving in this direction against the flow of current, then that kind of movement is called upstream. If you are moving along the direction of the flow of water or along the river, if you are moving along the river, then that kind of movement is called downstream. And if you are moving against the flow of river, then that kind of movement is known as upstream. So if you are moving along the river or along the flow of current or water, then what will be the combined speed? Here the speed of boat in still water is x. Now agar aap nav mein yahan pe baithe hue hain aur river ke flow ke direction mein agar jate hain, to jo flow of water hai wo bhi aapko pull karegi kis speed se? अपने स्पीड से. सो कंबाइन स्पीड विल बी एक्स प्लस वाई किमी पर आवर. और इसे क्या बोलते हैं? इसे हम बोलेंगे इसे हम बोलेंगे डाउन स्ट्रीम। सो डाउन स्ट्रीम को हम डीएस से डिनोट करेंगे, देन डीएस विल बी एक्स प्लस वाई किलोमीटर पर आवर। सपोज इफ यू आर मूविंग अगेंस्ट द फ्लो ऑफ वाटर, देन दैट काइंड ऑफ मूवमेंट विल बी अपस्ट्रीम एंड द स्पीड विल बी कॉल्ड अपस्ट्रीम स्पीड। ओके, देन व्हाट विल बी द ओवरऑल स्पीड, व्हाट विल बी द इफेक्ट ऑफ वाटर, फ्लो ऑफ वाटर। इफ यू आर मूविंग अगेंस्ट द फ्लो ऑफ वाटर, अगेंस्ट द करेंट, देन द स्पीड ऑफ बोट विल बी एक्स, एंड वेन यू आर मूविंग अगेंस्ट द फ्लो ऑफ वाटर देन द मोमेंट ऑफ वाटर विल पुल यू, ओके, पुल यू बैक विद व्हाट स्पीड, विद इट्स ओन स्पीड, देन दैट स्पीड विल बी रिड्यूस एक्स माइनस वाई किमी पर आवर। सो ds डाउन स्ट्रीम स्पीड ऑफ द बोट विल बी x प्लस वाई किलोमीटर पर आवर एंड अप स्ट्रीम स्पीड ऑफ द बोट विल बी x माइनस वाई किलोमीटर पर आवर। ओके, दिस इज इक्वेशन फर्स्ट एंड दिस इज इक्वेशन सेकेंड। नाउ ds वॉज x प्लस वाई इक्वेशन फर्स्ट एंड us इज इक्वल टू x माइनस वाई इक्वेशन सेकेंड। नाउ सपोज इक्वेशन फर्स्ट प्लस इक्वेशन सेकेंड, इफ यू एड इक्वेशन फर्स्ट एंड इक्वेशन सेकेंड देन व्हाट यू विल गेट, यू विल गेट 2x, बिकॉज इफ यू एड दिस टू इक्वेशन देन लेफ्ट हैंड साइड विल बी एडेड विद द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, राइट हैंड साइड विल बी एडेड विद द राइट हैंड साइड, देन राइट हैंड साइड विल बी x प्लस वाई प्लस x माइनस वाई, हियर प्लस वाई एंड माइनस वाई विल बी कैंसिल्ड आउट, सो रिमेनिंग विल बी x प्लस x 2x इज इक्वल टू हियर ds प्लस us, नाउ x इज इक्वल टू ds प्लस us डिवाइडेड बाय 2 किमी पर आवर। ओके, नाउ इन सेकेंड केस इफ यू सब्ट्रैक्ट इक्वेशन फर्स्ट इक्वेशन सेकेंड फ्रॉम इक्वेशन first, then what you will get, here you will get, now if you subtract equation second from equation first then x plus y minus x plus y, because if you subtract then this minus will become plus and this plus will become minus, so here x and x will be cancelled out and what will be remaining, 2y is equal to ds minus us divide ds minus us, so y is equal to ds minus us divided by 2. What is x? This is the speed of boat in still water, and what is y? Speed of river or speed of water or speed of current. Okay, so we will use these tricks, these formulas while solving the question related to this topic. So let's move and solve some question for clear understanding of this concept. Suppose a man can row upstream at 14 km per hour. A man can row upstream at 14 km per hour and downstream at 20 km per hour. Find the speed of man in still water. It means we have to find out speed of boat in still water or speed of man in still water. Then what we have to find out? Value of x. What will be the value of x? Okay. And what is given? A man can row upstream at 14 km per hour. Upstream matlab means against the flow of water, then this is denoted by US and value of US is 14 km per hour. And what is value of DS? And downstream at 20 km per hour, it means it is given that DS is equal to 20 km per hour. And what we have to find out? We have to find out value of x. Then you know x is equal to ds plus us divided by 2. And we will just simply put these values in these formulas. 20 plus 14 divided by 2. It means 34 divided by 2 means 17 km per hour. So our answer will be option C, 17 km per hour. Now we will see the next question. What is next question? A man can row a certain distance. A man can row a certain distance upstream at 13 km per hour. Okay? And the same distance downstream at 27 km per hour. Find the speed of current. Find the speed of current. Means suppose this is a river. A river is flowing in this direction. Okay? This is river and river is flowing in this direction. A man rows certain distance upstream, means against the flow of current. Means the person is moving against the flow of current certain distance at 13 km per hour. It means it is given that US is equal to 13 km per hour. Okay? And same distance downstream at 27 km per hour, and same distance downstream is person is moving along the flow of water, then this is speed will be ds and value of ds is 27 km per hour. So the value of ds and us is already given, and we have to find out speed of current. Speed of current means speed of water or speed of river, okay, or speed of steam. So we have to find out value of y. What will be the value of y? Y here, y means we have already discussed, we will use y in this topic as a speed of river or speed of steam or speed of current. So value of y, what will be the value of y? We have to find out this. So you know y is equal to ds minus us divided by 2, and we will find the value of y just putting these values in these formulas. So 27 minus 13 divided by 2. So what will be the value? 14 divided by 2, it means 7 km per hour. So our answer will be option B, which is 7 km per hour. So speed of current will be 7 km per hour. Okay, just moving at next questions. Next question is, a boat running downstream, a boat running downstream covers a distance of 112 km in 4 hours. Okay, suppose this is a river, this is a river, and river is flowing in this direction. River is flowing in this direction, okay, and distance from this point A and this point B is 112 km, okay, and the boat running downstream covers a distance of 112 km in 4 hours. It means a boat is going from point A to point B in 4 hours, okay, and covering 112 km distance. while covering the same distance of steam, means from B to A, covering same distance of steam, it takes 7 hours. Means while covering the same distance in the opposite direction, it means again the flow of water, it is 7 hours. Okay, then what will be the speed of boat in still water? We have to find out again the value of x. What will be the value of s? Here x is speed of boat in still water. So to find out the value of x, we must have to find out what will be the speed of boat along the current and speed of boat against the current. It means we have to find out first value of ds, downstream speed, and value of us, upstream speed. Then downstream speed will be ds, and ds will be, what will be the ds? You know, simply speed is equal to distance upon time, and in downstream, the distance covered along the current, along the flow of river is 112 kilometer, and how much time it is taking? 4 hours divided by 4, then this will be 4 to 8 28 kilometer per hour. Okay, now what will be the value of US, upstream speed? Here upstream speed will be 112. Now in up, again the flow of water, flow of river, the boat is covering the same distance in, but in 7 hours. So what will be the speed? 112 divided by 7, this will be 16 kilometer per hour. So we got ds is equal to 28 kilometer per hour and us is equal to 16 kilometer per hour. So what will be the value of x? Value of x will be x is equal to ds plus us divided by 2. So we will just add these values and divide by 2, we will get our answer. So 28 plus 16 divided by 2, this is 44 divided by 2 is me 22 kilometer per hour, 22 kilometer per hour. So our answer will be option C. So option C will be the right answer for these questions. Okay, now we will see the next question. This is, a boat goes 320 kilometer downstream. A boat goes 320 kilometer downstream and 140 kilometer upstream and takes 6 hours to cover each distance. Suppose this is a river. Suppose this is a river. Okay. A river is flowing in this direction. Okay. This is point A, and this is point B. Okay, and suppose this is distance, this is downstream and this will be upstream. Okay, so if you are covering 320 kilometer downstream in 6 hours, then value of ds will be what? Here ds is equal to 320 divided by 6 kilometer per hour, or we can simplify it or leave this. Okay, and value of us will be, upstream speed will be 140 divided by 6 kilometer per hour. So we got value of ds and us as this. Now what we have to find out? Find the velocity of current. It means we have to find out value of y. We have to find out value of y. It means this This is the speed of current or speed of river or speed of water or speed of stream. Okay, so how do we find value of y? You know y is equal to what? Ds plus Us, Ds minus Us divided by 2. Ds minus Us divided by 2. So Ds is 320 by 6 minus Us means 140 divided by 6 and overall divided by 2. So if we take LCM of this 6 and 6, the overall will be 6 and we will subtract 320, 140 from 320. The what will be the answer? Here you will get 0, here you will get 8 and here you will get 1. Okay, now it is divided by 2. Then what will, this is not a proper ratio. Now, suppose this is A upon B divided by C, then what is the proper ratio? A upon B into C, A upon B into C. Then what will be this ratio? 180 divided by 6 into 12. Okay, so what will be the answer? This will be 12, or 12, 1 is 12, 12, 5 is 60, means 15 kilometer per hour, 15 kilometer per hour. So your answer will be option B, okay, 15 kilometer per hour. Okay, now moving in the next question. So next question is, a boat takes 3 hours 45 minutes to cover a distance of 15 kilometer downstream and it takes 2 hours 30 minutes to cover a distance of 5 kilometer upstream. Now speed of current. So here the time is value of ds. What we have to find out? We have to find out value of y. What will be the value of y? Means speed of current. Now what will be the value of ds? Ds is we are boat is just covering 15 kilometer per hour, 15 kilometer downstream in 3 hours 45 minutes. So 15 speed is equal to distance upon time. Here time is time. So value of t1 will be, time will be 3 hours and 45 minutes. If you convert minute into hours, so you have to divide 45 by 60. So overall time will be 3 hours plus 3 upon 4 hours. So this will be, if you convert this in proper fraction, then fraction will be 15 divided by 4 hours. 15 divided by 4 hours. Okay. Now just convert another time, t2 is equal to 2 hours and 30 minutes, then this will be 2 plus 30 means minute means 1 by 2 hours, then it will be 5 upon 2 hours. So here ds is equal to speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is 15 kilometer downstream, you are covering, boat is covering this distance in 3 hours 45 minutes, it means 15 upon 5 hours. So 15 upon 5 hours, 15 upon 4 hours. Okay, then what will be the proper ratio? This will be 4 kilometer per hour. Okay, now value of Us will be what? upstream, how much distance is covered, being covered? 5 kilometers. So 5 divided by distance, speed is equal to distance upon time. So here time is 5 upon 2. So proper ratio will be 2 km per hour. So value of ds is 4 km per hour and value of us is 2 km per hour. Now what we have to find out? We have to find out value of y. It means y is equal to what? Ds minus us divided by 2. Here ds, value of ds is 4 minus 2 divided by 2. It means you will get 1 kilometer per hour. 1 kilometer per hour. So option A will be the right answer. So in this way we will use only this trick while solving different type of questions, and with the help of some other related concept of speed, time and distance. Okay, so I hope you will be enjoying the class, and understanding the concept in a very simple way. So that's all for today, and we are meeting again in the next session. Till that, thank you so much.